want to be a lobster man. Tell me, do you think you have what it takes to join me on my crew? Because you see, being a lobster man isn't like being a fisherman, or a whale hunter, or any other aquatic-based job like a dolphin trainer, or a tourboat captain slash ordained minister for wedding purposes only. It's a way of life that transcends race, religion, and sexual orientation. You see, one night when I was a wee little lad, my father absconded with me in the middle of the night. He took me to live with him on a houseboat, and we spent many years there together in total bliss until one day he was slain by a creature of the sea. You see, one day, the one day a month that we came on shore for supplies, my father saw a billboard advertising the Shamu exhibit at SeaWorld, and he became so excited that he made a beeline for the ticket office and fell straight down a manhole. And on that day, I swore that I'd return to my boat and become a master of the seas, so that one day I could make Shamu my bitch and make him pay for what he'd done to my father. One day, my second first mate was reeling in a catch, and he tripped. My third first mate, aye, a fate worse than death. He found out he'd gotten a woman pregnant, and I mean, who am I to stand between a man and his son, so I had to let him go. One day, during my tenure with my fourth first mate, a storm rocked the boat, and a wave sent a shark on board. The shark bit my hand clean off. After trying to fight back with him, I realized, forget that, I don't have to beat the shark, I just have to beat the other guy. So I threw my first mate, Johnny, at the shark, and I said, every man for himself, and I ran below deck. A few weeks later, when we docked for supplies, that first mate disappeared, probably on account of how he'd committed a serious crime. But I didn't even notice that he'd abandoned me until 2 days later when I asked him to brew me an apple teeny hard on the teeny, and I realized that he'd replaced himself with a scarecrow. After that, I hired my seventh first mate, and we had a pretty good relationship until one night he tried to murder me in my sleep. You see, he was actually my fourth first mate, Johnny, wearing a beard he'd bought from Party City. It turns out he'd escaped from the shark, swam ashore, and married a woman, had a few kids. But all that time, while he was raising that family, he trained to kill me in combat to get revenge for me abandoning him to the sharks. I don't know what he was so upset about. I lost my hand! I lost my bride! Johnny still has his hand! Johnny has his bride! What a crybaby. Now, before I offer you this job in any official capacity, I need to issue you a couple of warnings. You see, a lobster man, he leads a solitary life. The last time I participated in an act of sexual intercourse was when my parents conceived me. Now, all that being said, do you think you're ready for the job?
I thought this was for an interview at Red Lobster. Where am I?
Huh?
Oh yeah, I thought lobster man might have been a metaphor, like how they call him sandwich artist.
Jesus Christ, kid, you know not everything's a metaphor, right? I mean, come on, I teach lobsterial arts, not remedial language arts. Get it together, you stinky, stinky boy.
Hi, you must be Chantry Rickles. I'm the manager. Nice to meet you. Hi, who are you?
I'm the lobster man.
The lobster man?
I'm here to audition for Rock Lobster, the musical.
Oh, yeah, sorry, you're in the wrong place.
Oh, sorry, I saw the sign, it said
no,
lobster.
No, it's fine, it's completely understandable, don't worry about it, seriously.
So, how do I get to the studio for the...
Oh, the studio? Yeah. You're just going to take a left out of here. There'll be a little door on the end of the hallway. It's about, like, this tall, so get down on your knees, and you're going to knock a few times. I think, like, 9 or 8 times
what's it's going to be
on the way. Oh, shush. So,
I don't know what's
you're going to knock on the door, and a troll is going to come out of it, and it'll ask you three riddles. Now, the first two riddles you don't need to get right, but the third one you have to get right. It's going to be, a distance velocity question. You know, it's like a question, but it's got a tricky... Shut up. So,
Erik, I don't know if this is working out.
Okay, you know what? It's Charles's fault. That shirt is obviously too big for him. I'm thinking it. We're all thinking it.
Hey, right? Hey. In my defense, you woke me up at 11:30.
How do you want to end it instead?